It seems to be a usual quad, doesn't it? But something is wrong here. What about the engine noise? I'll tell you everything now. Let's go. Hi there, as usual it's me, just a voiceover, and you're watching Review Machines. And today we've got for the review one more unique machine. This time we converted all-wheel drive ATV CF Moto X8 into full electric. There was 800cc engine that was replaced with powerful electric motors. And today we are going to do the first test of this conversion. By the way, all the works were done by our friends from Emax Electric Tuning Studio. Well, and I am looking forward to show you all the details of construction. So get comfortable, my friends, it's high time to begin. The original quad is a big two-seats machine. The most part of the transmission, engine and CVT were removed. Instead, we placed here the huge battery made of LG elements with 72 volts power and 240 ampere hours capacity. The battery fits here beautifully, it looks like a serial production solution. The hardest task of the whole project was to convert the full drive transmission. To solve this task, Emax engineers made special reducers. It's absolutely waterproof gears, with belts that transfer the drive from electric motors to the differentials. As to the motors, there are two of them, at the front and from behind. The power of each motor is 22 kW. The charger is integrated into the body. The battery can be charged by a standard socket. There are some loose ends that we still didn't finish. The lights don't work, the dashboard isn't modified. So now here we have just a battery indicator. The handling is the simplest. This button turns on the power. The next controls the full drive. And the third one turns on the reverse. Well, that were the main features of the conversion. All the rest details we will discuss later. And now it's time to go. We start our test on asphalt to check the speed performance of the machine. And first of all, let's see how it starts. As we can see, it takes off and speeds up so fast. You know, it's very hard to convey all the emotions when you push the throttle on this conversion. But it's really insane stuff. The main task when you start moving is to keep the handles tight, not to fall down from the quad. We have here an instantaneous reaction on the throttle, cause there is no any more huge amounts of gears and parts of the combustion engine. There is just straight electric drive. Well, it definitely speeds up faster than the original quad with the gas 800cc engine. On the other hand, this conversion was done in favor of torque, not in favor of maximum speed, so the speed is slightly less here than on the original quad. As we can see, the maximum speed is 85 km per hour. Now we are moving on a forest road at a rather high speed, thanks the suspension system allows us to do that. By the way, speaking about the other features of the conversion, all its parts, the motors, the battery, controllers and reducers are absolutely waterproof. As to the weight, the conversion weighs approximately the same as the original quad. But the most impressive feature of the project is certainly the quietness. The matter is that the engine noise is one of the most irritating characteristics of any quad. Moreover, it may annoy not only you, but also all your neighbors. That is why many people don't like quad riders. And this problem has absolutely gone here. Let's watch the same move by the gas quad and the electric one. The only noise we can hear with electric watt is the sounds of the breaking twigs when we are moving right through the forest. Besides, it's so fun to watch the reaction of the other riders when they see our big watt cutting its way through the bushes without any engine noise. Some of them were really shocked. And now it's time to test our quad in mud. Though I think you may know the off-roading capabilities of such quad, they are really capable of it. But again, it's so strange to watch the big and heavy quad going hard across the dirt without any rotating engine noise. All we hear is just the sound of spreading dirt and water. Besides, I should mention that the electric torque also does a lot of good when in dirt. You can feel it so precisely. The throttle is very delicate to touch. At any moment, you can steer a finger a little bit, and the quad jumps off from any trap like a beast. Also, it's very handy feature to switch on the reverse mode only by pressing one button. This feature might help you greatly not to get stuck in the hardest conditions. And now we are approaching to the main test for today. Definitely it's a range test. How far can it actually go? Well, let's find out. Now we come back home to recharge the battery, and then we'll start the new trip to test the total range. Well, it's a new day. The battery is fully charged, and we start GPS tracker to measure the distance. By the way, we will be accompanied by other quads, and let's refuel one of them to find out who will go further, fully charged electric quad or gasoline one with full tank. As to our today's route, firstly we will have few miles going on asphalt, but it's not right to test the ATV on asphalt, that is why the most part of our trip today is rough terrain, dirt and various obstacles. So we are leaving the asphalt for the more proper conditions. When we started this test, we didn't have an idea how far we would go. That is why, to be on a safe side, we took a generator with us and mounted it on a trunk. But we will not use it until the battery is dead. After about 3 hours of our trip, we stopped to have a snack and to meet one more quad rider on Polaris Big Boss. The route meantime is getting harder, but with the Big Boss support, we don't afraid of any obstacles. We are going further, crossing quite tough off-roading sites, huge paddocks, rivers and swamps. We even used the winch several times. Undoubtedly, it's a very hard test for the battery. And you should know, we are doing now not a traditional range test going on asphalt. It's off-roading range test, and it's absolutely different thing in terms of battery load. And again, I want to say a few words about one of the most significant advantages of the electric conversion. Again, about the quietness. The lack of noise is especially important at such a long trip. You are moving without any irritating sound and the smell of exhaust. All you hear is a wind, bird songs and other sounds of nature, and you may really enjoy your adventure without any disturbance. Thank you. Meantime, it's getting dark, and we start to realize that we will not be able to empty the battery today, so it was absolutely unnecessary to take the generator with us. Nevertheless, we can demonstrate now how it works. When the generator is working, we can proceed moving. And if the speed is under 30 km per hour, the battery won't be discharged. So it's quite a useful feature if you are going to the distant expeditions on an electric quad. Well, it's almost dark outside and we don't have any lights, so it's time to go back home. And summing up my impressions of today's trip, I should say the conversion is definitely quite successful. We've got a powerful electric quad that is good for all kinds of terrain. It's fast and smooth, it's almost noiseless. And one more thing. For example, Polaris Big Boss has spent today about $15 for fuel, but we've spent a way less for electricity. Meantime, we run out of fuel on our gasoline quad, but we still have a lot of energy in battery. But it's time to come back home now, and it's high time to check the result. And the result is 57 kilometers. And we should remember that the route was pretty hard. It was a real off-roading. Moreover, we still have 43% of battery, so I should say the range is really impressive. Thanks for having a ride with us. Please post your comments what you think of this conversion. Consider subscribing the channel if you like this video. Stay with us, it will be many more interesting materials here. Goodbye.